doing in there, huh? You're a long way from the water.
Hot out here.
It's almost July in Alabama. Of course it's hot.
Yeah. Well, out here it feels like the desert. Battery's on, dude.
You gonna check it?
Nope, good to go. Is it 12:30?
Yeah.
That's probably another reason why it's so hot.
Wow, you think?
Middle of the day.
Seems to be a good spot for them. They come to this little mineral thing here a lot, don't they?
Mm-hmm. Especially last year. So hopefully they'll continue.
Yeah, I mean, we had some good pictures of some nice bucks here last year.
That hole wasn't there either. Dug a hole.
And our stand was right back over there. What's that, 100 yards maybe?
Probably not quite.
The cutover sure has grown up.
Yeah. Last year you could actually hunt
way out there.
The whole thing. Now.
Well, if you remember, I killed two bucks right over there last year.
Yeah.
And
I remember having to.
Well, that was a heck of a drag.
Mm-hmm.
I think I said, what did I say? I'll never shoot another deer out there again, ever.
And then Elizabeth did.
Yeah.
Had to drag that one too.
It's kind of unhuntable right now. Until some of this stuff dies off. Well, of course you can't hunt it right now, but I mean later on it's still going to be pretty high.
Uh-huh. Nah, it'll be late January, February. And it'll be died off enough you'll be able to see then.
Yeah.
That's when they'll start moving anyway.
Well, there you go. There's some more powder. Hope the deer enjoy it. You know, I always drive past this one and never notice it anymore. That's one of my old cutty bags.
Yeah. I'm still amazed that it still works.
Is it still taking good pictures?
So far. It's got some kind of permanent little watermark right in there, but it's still got battery life too.
Golly, you know how old that thing is?
Shoot, I've been using it for, 5 or 6 years?
At least.
From what I've seen on trail cameras, if you can use it for 5 or 6 years, that's
pretty
good.
You're good. My dad and I bought those. I guarantee it's been 10 years ago.
Is it? This is more of our security camera.
Yeah.
To see who all is riding around out here. But what's crazy is it's just a camera on a tree on the road. on the main road, the beach is right down there. Deer, coyotes, pigs, everything walk right down this road.
Remember that time we got the picture of that guy walking across here?
Yeah, right there.
That was scary.
Still don't know who that was.
You better look around before you start just squatting down right there.
Cart's full.
How long has it been since you checked that one?
A couple weeks. Well, nah, it's probably been more than that. But it's still going to be a lot on an 8 gig cart.
Yeah, do you think that some of this grass might be triggering it or something?
Nah. I think it's a bunch of pigs running around.
Probably. There's the trough that we filled up the other day. Looks like it's still got some stuff in it. We'll see if they've come eating anything out of it.
About half of it's gone. When did we put that out? Like, what day was it? Like 2 days ago?
2 days ago.
Yeah.
They already hit it pretty good.
About took out most of it.
Most of the pellets.
Half of them.
Hope those peas start growing.
Yeah, me too. I did a lot of bouncing on that pea patch.
Yeah, I know. I mean, it's in an area where the pigs hadn't been there for a while,
mm-hmm.
but it's still kind of bumpy in there.
Well, the plow makes those little ridges in it and stuff.
The more you hit it with a plow through the years, it'll smooth it down as long as we can keep them out of there.
That little blind.
Yeah, we got to do something with that this year.
Well, it's going to come in handy. It's about the perfect spot right now.
It is. It just needs to be, what's the word? Snake-proofed?
I mean, would you...
What word?
Would you... How much money would it take for you to unzip that thing and walk into it right now?
How much you got?
I mean, that's probably 2 or 3 rattlesnakes in there, man.
I'm going to look.
No.
Well, it's not going to get any cooler before we have to get in anyways.
Well, that's true. Well, October it'll be 91.
In your case, it'll be a bunch of yellow jackets or wasps.
Yeah, I know.
But not near as much of a fall.
No, I mean, if I fell out of that, I probably would just like roll. Sprain something instead of break it.
Drop and roll.
I don't know if we need to talk about that.
Why?
That's bad luck, man. But yeah, my luck, I'd walk in there and it'd be like 19 yellow jacket nests in there. Huh. I'd become more scared of wasps down here than I am snakes.
Mm-hmm. I'm still worried about snakes.
I know you are. You always will be.
Yeah.
This is our mineral lake that won't stop growing.
Yeah, it started out to be just that right there.
Yeah.
And now it's worked its way down. And we put all the stuff in this side this year. Once again, the hogs had a lot to do with that.
True. A lot of deer there.
Yeah. We got some good pictures on this lick last summer. A lot of good bucks running together.
That's what's crazy about out here. There's a lot of good deer and a lot of deer. You just gotta fight the hogs to find the deer.
Well, yeah, we do now, don't we? I've literally seen them, you know, run deer off a feeder many times.
Yep.
They probably do the same thing on these licks.
And the fields.
Yeah, you're right. I mean, they pretty much just run off the field when the pigs come on the field.
That'll probably work better with new batteries.
That's one thing about running these trail cameras every year. We spend a fortune on battery.
Normally don't buy this, normally buy the 72 pack.
Right, exactly. Hey, it is what it is.
Several,
you know,
times a year.
Yeah.
Thank goodness they have cards in them now instead of film. Because that would be a lot of money getting film developed.
Yeah.
Where I used to get 24 pictures in a home on the camera.
That's right.
And you'd be lucky if you got four pictures of deer and everything else was just butts and stuff. So
it's been many years ago, but I can remember running a trail camera with a camera in it.
Uh-huh.
And now you get those 8 gigabyte cards and
or bigger.
Yeah, it's going good though. I mean, we always run good cameras down here, and I mean, by the time the season starts, we have a good idea of our population, so it pays off. That's any, you know, one thing I would say is if you got a piece of property, put some cameras on it and then you'll know what you got. Maybe put something in like this that'll bring them to it so you can check out all your bucks. That's what we do. Take a look at what we got. Ooh, that's a nice one.
Mm-hmm. It probably work, huh?
stuff until I finally got used to it anyway. These $75 rods, both of these rods are going for about $75 on eBay. I got them on Facebook Marketplace right now. I'm waiting, so I just put them up there. So
they're going to blow by.
Oh, yeah.
That's the one that killed our feeders.
It's like 9 o'clock in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
Hey.
Oh.
A little bit of everything.